All right then, it's super late. I'm sorry. This was literally out of my control, and I had no option but to do it like this because life just likes to get in your way, and it sucks, honestly. But when it comes down to things, though, today we got the Q&A, a nice 19-kinda-ish comments that was sent in, and to be perfectly honest, just a round of everything. I'll give you a self-made question myself. Out of all the accolades and all the accomplishments, hopefully in the future that I'll get from this channel, what is the one major thing that I really want this channel to do? Now, of all the things I really want to do, all the nice little figurines that hopefully I'll get sponsored to get one day, all the damn adult doll toys that, you know, get sent my damn way that maybe or may not look like Nahida, maybe. But when it comes down to things though, the one thing that I really want out of this entire channel, well, mainly, that would be just for bragging rights, find some way to work with the people that made High School DxD. That would be the biggest thing, because I just want one official picture of Jay and Koniko together. I don't know how that would work. I don't know if that will work at all. I don't know if it's even possible, but I want to see an official picture of Jay and Koniko happy together, just having a good ass time, right? That's all I effing want. If I can get that, holy shit, I made it. I am at the peak. No one can ever take that shit from me. That is the one major thing I would want to see happen. Just somehow, Jay inserted himself legitimately in the DxD universe. Now that being said, let's get to y'all's questions. First off, come from AGamer2000. Favorite game? Obviously, Kingdom Hearts 2. Obviously, Kingdom Hearts just in general. It almost was, like, a few years ago, thrown off by Persona 5. But it's Kingdom Hearts, honestly, which, you know what, not necessarily anything too surprising with that. I've said that many times. Showed you in gameplay. Showed you recently in one video with Kingdom Hearts in the background of the gameplay where I whooped ass in Kingdom Hearts 2. Honestly, I know Kingdom Hearts 2, like, it's the back of my hand. So of course it's gotta be the favorite game of all games, honestly. What is your favorite Neptunia waifus? Fun fact, I don't know shit about Neptunia. I've never seen a singular moment of Neptunia. If I had to say any character though, without even knowing the name or looking it up, it's the one that wears, I think, the purplish kind of jacket. That's the one. I think that's the main character. Is that the main character? I'm not necessarily sure, but I've never seen Neptunia. I've heard about it. I've obviously seen something of it, but I don't know dick about Neptunia. Anyway, that was from Social Traffic Network. Okay, we have an Omega Mighty 9007, which says, when are we going to get the video about the Astolfo's Hentai manga review? When the hell did I ever say that? I ain't never say that day in my damn life. Tell you what, for you Astolfo people, or if this is the same person as Astolfo, tell you damn what, if you somehow make a picture or find some way, make a picture of Jay clapping Astolfo's cheeks, it could be a female version of Astolfo or a boy version, or femboy at least, doesn't matter, honestly, it's fiction. When it comes down to it, if you can find some way to make a fire ass picture of that and send that shit to me, then fine. I will do one Astolfo Dojin review, if that's what everybody else wants as well. Mug9591 basically says, Koniko looking like she's about to pop you. Yeah, I mean, how would you feel if somebody came through on your big day on stage to basically be like, yeah, it's my time to shine, I'm about to steal the damn show, only for your dumbass husband to come through and just try to be on some nonsense. Yeah, I would beat his ass too, honestly. This is the thing about Jay, he doesn't necessarily care. Sometimes he don't care at the wrong effing times. You also had a second question basically saying, if you could, what are the countries which you travel to? Also, long time no see, you're no longer on Twitter. I do have a Twitter, obviously, now, but when it comes down to things, if you haven't followed it, please follow, so there you go. And countries I would like to travel to, I don't actually have a list of countries. Outside of Japan, which is obviously like the main one, I don't know where I would want to go, honestly. And Japan was like the biggest thing since I was a child. First of all, actually, I didn't know where anime was made from as a child. I always thought it was China. Funny enough, crazy, right? But as I learned, I was like, oh, so Japan makes it. All right, so we gotta go to Japan then, right? And then when I found out that Akihabara exists, an anime city, I'm like, oh hell yeah. So before all these other people, all these VTubers and all don't come through, be like, I want to go to Japan. I got passports. We're going to Japan now. No, bitch. I've always wanted to go. It's been the longest dream of mine to go to the place where anime was made. So of course, I want to go there. Asuka Yotsuya asks, do you listen to rock number one and do you listen to metal number two? I do not listen to metal. I sometimes listen to rock. I mean, if you basically played, you know, like WWE old games, like back in the day, like versus, like Raw versus SmackDown, or, you know, things like Just Bring It or Here Comes the Pain, and you heard the soundtracks from them. Yeah. If you honestly listen to some type of rock, you probably listen to that, and that's probably where you got to start from. I listen to some. Linkin Park is pretty decent, right? I like Breaking the Habit because it's just nice, and it's kind of motivational too. So there's some rock songs I like. Some older wrestling games with rock songs in it, that's in it that I absolutely like too. So, you know, there's a few songs I like, but I'm not super heavy into metal. I actually like jazz a lot more too, right? Because it just, something about jazz just feels smooth, right? You can have your jazz, you can have your, you know, K-pop is kind of alright. J-pop is more where I'm at though, but you can have that, you know, a little bit of classical music with violins and stuff, you know, that's something good too, right? There's quite a few pieces of genre that I like. Envy, the homunculus Mard Gear 8922, long behind name, and you basically say senpai is looking breedable as always. Well, I mean, first of all, who looking mad breedable? Who you talking about looking mad breedable? Because you're damn right, I do look breedable as hell. Can't get it though. Anyway, Rin Suzugamori 1427 says, if you have a favorite trading card game, what is it? It is time to duel. It is Yu-Gi-Oh. To be perfectly honest, does that surprise anybody? Not necessarily. And here's the thing about Yu-Gi-Oh, right? I used to get my ass beat by with my brother, like, a lot, honestly. I've only won maybe like 2 or 3 matches against him. I've never won that many. Of all, like, the other matches that we played, I haven't won shit because I was ass at Yu-Gi-Oh. Now I'm a lot better. Granted, I only have like the older cards of the game, like the first, second, third Yu-Gi-Oh, like all the way up to GX, 5Ds. I have some cards from 5Ds. And that's about it where my card collection ends. I have all the Blue Eyes, well, at least 3 of them, and then I have Blue Eyes. I think I have Blue Eyes. Like the 1000. No, is it? I can't remember what future card I have of the Blue Eyes. I think it's either the 3-headed dragon. There's like a 3-headed dragon variation, or like a... I'll put it in the video to show you which one I have, because I really can't remember, but I have a Blue-Ass Fusion somewhere. Grims0694 says, favorite Persona waifu? Rize. Like, no discussion, no debate. Granted, I don't know everybody from Persona 3, like, in a super deep way, because I never played Persona 3, and I know Reload is out now. And I know people are probably playing the shit out of it now. Basically, Rize from Persona 4. Like, and Fi has some fine-ass women too, right? Fi definitely has some fine-ass women. But for me personally, it's gonna have to be Rize. Because Makoto is a little too serious. Even though she got ass, Makoto's a little too serious. An is a bit of a angry-ass person constantly. Futaba just feels too childish. Haru is just... Well, Haru's okay. But I don't necessarily have a... taste for Haru, if I'm being honest. But still, nonetheless, yeah, it's Rize 100%. Renice as a noob says, do you plan on trying out different platforms like Rumble or Odyssey or an alt Twitter? I have Blue Sky. I know that's, like, you know, something that has like a code that you have to use to get in, which I have multiple sets of codes, and I have not been on Blue Sky in a minute. But yeah, I have Blue Sky, so if you want to go follow me there, if you have an account there, hit me up there. That's like a place where I'm at. If I were to have like a backup place, maybe Rumble. I don't know. It depends on how much shit can you get away with on Rumble or Odyssey. It will depend on which one you get away with more shit, because if I can't talk about anything like we do here, then damn it, that kind of beats the purpose of this. So, you know, we'll see how that kind of goes, but maybe Rumble. I don't know. I have to look around to see. Sleepy Rulu says, who's your favorite OC to draw? It is Saki, without a doubt. And honestly, with all the Kakatsu characters that you've seen so far, they only been made in Kakatsu. That's where they started from, and I have not translated almost any of them into like actual drawings. The only people that has been translated into drawings have been Shoko and Blue. That's literally it. And there's just a plethora of other characters you haven't seen yet. Or maybe just over time, I'll just slowly show you over time. Because, hell, I even have a spider character that you don't even know about. Because you know, I was like, you know what, I have arachnophobia, but F it, I want to make a spider character, because there's so much loot shit that you can do, which she has like normal body, but like multiple eyes, and then also shoot silk out of her titties, which is amazing, and it's also edible, because why not, right? So there's like plenty of other characters I do definitely have, and Saki is by far one of the characters I drew the most out of, outside of maybe Momo or something like that, but when it comes to it, yeah, Saga's probably the most, because her hair probably is also the one that changed a lot too, from being whack as hell to being pretty okay, but it doesn't make sense, like drawing wise, and then kind of going to something else that kind of make it stick nowadays, and what she kind of looked like now. So yeah, Saga's like the one that I mainly drew, but again, there's other characters I have, and other characters I haven't even created yet in that story to, you know, kind of draw out, because also with the Spider Girl, which I call Stella, apparently when it comes down to things, anytime she uses silk out of her boobs, it grows bigger and smaller depending on how much silk is in there. So that's also a fun thing to know. So if you want to get that show going, help me build this channel up in the place it needs to be built. Ephesia, did I say that right? I feel like I didn't. 3251 says, I'm curious, if you didn't have your YouTube channel, what other media did you use to tell your story, comic or novel, etc.? Honestly, I hope that don't ever happen, but when it comes down to it, I would probably still stick to Twitter or Blue Sky to tell the story. And speaking of the story, that's kind of like something I've been trying to figure out where to go with that. I have an idea what to do with the story. I think I know what the big ending part of it might be. I just don't know how to kind of connect the dots of where to go from A to B, and I need to put something out this month, obviously. But when it comes down to the story though, it'd probably just be, you know, Twitter and Blue Sky still, because that's probably the places where it's going to be, you know, wrote up the most, if anything. And lastly, Tomato Sauce basically says, if you had the ability to shapeshift into anything or anyone you wanted to, what would you turn into first? All right, so I thought about this one a lot, honestly. So when it comes down to it, if I really had the power of shapeshifting and literally fiction and all that type of stuff was within my reach to shapeshift, number one, I'm turning into Konako and doing the most wildin' shit. I'm being very honest with you. I'm gonna be doing the most wildin' shit. Someone be like, damn, that Konako cosplayer knew how to bust it down. So that's literally gonna be like the one major thing I do. Then obviously turn into myself, which is like the animated, you know, version of myself, which is Jay, obviously. So, you know, looking mad sexy as hell. Everybody be like, damn, I can't believe that K-pop singer is so fine, come through with the nice ass blue hair. So they're like, holy shit, this boy hot as hell. So yeah, that would be like another thing. I'll be on some toxic shit, I ain't gonna hold you. I would definitely be on some toxic shit if I could just shapeshift 100%, do some wild and things that probably shouldn't be done, but that's just how it's gonna be. But that is essentially all the questions that I have answered for you for this one. I like doing Q&As, not too much like I used to, but I do like doing, because it shows you the, I guess, the more candid side of my personality in person, honestly, which hopefully you can kind of see it as like a gateway to kind of understand what type of person I am, even if I don't talk about things super seriously. But yeah, I do like doing these things because it just kind of shows you the inside of a content creator a bit, where you don't really get that a lot these days. And a lot of these days, content creators be flip-flop so weird and, you know, be doing the most wackiest and wildin' things that don't necessarily need to be done. But still, doing things like this hopefully will show you, I guess, the humanity of me, I suppose, in some shape and form. So also, before you decide to click off the video, real quick, I do have an art tag that is X4Art on Twitter, literally hashtag X4Art. And, you know, you can use that if you want to make fan art of my character or any other characters that you want to do. Because I've been noticing some people saying they want to do some fan art and never really had like a tag for it or didn't know what the tag was. So remember, X4Art, it's always been there, but I guess someone really pay attention. But X4Art has always been like the tag on Twitter. So if you want to draw me banging Konako or something like that, you can absolutely do that. You want to draw me just solo looking nice and awesome as hell? Go ahead and do that. I'll be more than happy to retweet your work, honestly. So, you know, if you want to do some fan work, if you want to do some fan art, there's a lot of artists that we cover on this channel. There's a lot of people that I know that are artists, honestly, would like to see some, you know, fan work if you just want to, honestly. Also, I've been downloading and re-looking back at a lot of other people that have been, you know, drawing my character and essentially save a lot of those pictures and send them into like a folder for me so I can keep on to them. Not just to, you know, hold on to them because damn, these pictures look good. Not just for that, but also to keep myself to, you know, continue to do the right thing, to keep, you know, going in the path that hopefully will be good for everybody, not just for myself, but for you guys too. So that's also like another reason why I do feel like fan art is a bit important. And if you just want to, again, X4 art is the art tag to use on Twitter and really just in social media, just in general, if you just want to share your fan work, right? That's essentially all I have for you for this one, so hopefully you enjoy. If you did, be sure to like, share, subscribe, hit the bell notification on the way out. Also follow me on socials, and if less than the channel, Ko-Fi and Cash App is available as well. And until then, it's Boy J, signing off. Have a blessed day.